afternoon baseball here on the show. Today we've got a good matchup ahead between the New York Yankees and the Tampa Bay Rays. Stepping in, Gio Urshela, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Leading off the afternoon for the Yankees, the third baseman.
First pitch on its way.
Urshela.
Edge of the zone that time, taken and ruled a strike. High and deep down the left field line. And he will run this one down, moving to his right, and that's the first out of the inning. So the base is empty here with one away, and that'll bring up the outfielder Clint Frazier. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
I know he stole a strike right there, but he wants to get that curveball down or he's going to get hurt.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
I get it. He wants to see this guy's repertoire, but now he's behind in the count. Puts himself in a tough spot to hit.
Bases are empty, one man out. Outside and low that time. Now it's two balls and two strikes. Hopped up. Lau is there. And that's the second out of the inning. So bases are empty here with two gone. And that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. First pitch of the at bat. Inside with the fastball, it's 1-0. Two out, nobody on. Called strike at the knees. Evens the count at 1-1.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
2-1 the count. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
So a full count now.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Batting four.
And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. First pitch coming. Here it is.
You can bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you'd normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. 1-1 pitch is a circle change. It hits the target 1-2. From the belt. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. And that'll bring up Manuel Margot. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The center fielder, Manuel.
And the pitch.
Margot.
A ball and no strikes. Two and oh now. Margot doesn't usually enjoy left-handed pitching like this as much as he does at bats against right-handers. I'm not sure if it's a comfort thing or if he just sees the ball better coming from the right side, but that's the book on him at this point in his career. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
Torres picks it up, and there's one down now. Up next for the Rays, Yandy Diaz.
The third baseman, Yandy Diaz.
First pitch on its way. And this is just off the outside corner for a ball, 1-0. That is fouled away, one ball and one strike. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Judge is there, two down. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Randy Arozarena looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. The pitch. Bases are empty here with two men out. To first, scooped up, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. And that'll bring up Aaron Judge, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning.
Aaron.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Fouled away. Judge, who fittingly gets the nickname All Rise. He's in his fourth season as a major league player. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Oh, and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. Margot looks up and off the batter's eye for a home run. An impressive shot to dead center field.
Batting fifth.
And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres.
Gleyber Torres.
Popped him up. Diaz has a play. One out. Next for New York, Kyle Higashioka. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Higashioka.
And now a pitch on the way. Set to deliver the 0-1. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. This is line to left. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Digging in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. His career line against Waka. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Good changeup there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one. Line drive, base hit.
Batting nine, the first baseman.
Here's Jay Bruce now. Pitch out, nothing doing. Ready with the 1-0 now to Bruce.
Well, he's following the code not to miss down and into a lefty. Everything on the outer half of the plate.
And he'll dive back in safely. Yankees lead this 1-0 here in inning number two. And this one misses to Bruce as he moves out in front. It's 2-1.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Waka a check at first, and he's back easily. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Arozarena is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in is the power hitting second baseman, Brandon Lau.
The second baseman, number
ready
eight.
With the first pitch. Here it comes.
Ball one, no strike.
The 1-0 is a fastball down below the knees. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. And that's the first out. So one away here with the bases empty. And up next will be Willie Adames. First pitch coming. Here it is. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Here we go. Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two.
Every time you go out there to start a game on the mound, you hope to settle in quickly and get into a groove, and he's definitely done that so far in the early going. Looks like he could go pretty deep into this one.
Ready to deliver the 1-2.
I got the count.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Coming to the plate now, Michael Brasso. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. First pitch of the at bat. Fastball well outside.
Count 1-0.
That evens it up 1-1. A shot to first base and caught there to end the inning. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
Third baseman, Gio.
Here comes the first pitch. A ball and no strikes. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. And now a pitch on the way. Now a swing and a fly ball. And it's a foul ball. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. In now is the Yankees DH, Clint Frazier. He popped out in his first trip. Here's the pitch. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. Frazier, a native of Georgia. He was selected in the first round back in the draft of 2013.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
Adames is under this one, and he's got it for out number two. Digging in now for the Yankees, DJ LeMahieu reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. Now the pitch.
1-0.
Two out, nobody on. One ball, one strike, the count. One and two to DJ LeMahieu.
Two strikes.
Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2. The pitch. High in the air out to center field. Margot is camped under this one. As he puts this one away, the side is retired. Leading off the inning, Yoshi Tsutsugo. And they'll need him to get something going here.
The designated hitter, Yoshi.
Here comes the first pitch.
Tsutsugo.
Right there for strike one.
Like that pitch there. Lefty on lefty matchup. Curveball away to a lefty. Smart pitch.
Down and away, ball one. The 1-1 home is looked at for ball number two.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
Hit out towards second. Gloved by LeMahieu. And that's out number one. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And Austin Meadows will be the next to bat. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Starts him out with a curveball for a strike. One out, nobody on. And this is high, a ball and a strike.
I got one ball, one strike.
And he popped him up. Stanton coming on. That gets down, and the Rays' first hit of the game is going to be for extra bases. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Batting ninth, the catcher, Mike Zunino.
Here now is Mike Zunino as he'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. And he misses again, 2-0.
He's going to have a talk with the umpire after this half inning, because if he's not going to get those calls, he's got to come a little bit more over the heart of the plate, and that usually means damage done.
3-0 to him now. Pitch on its way now to Zunino, and he'll just float a change in here now for a strike. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two. 3-2 pitch. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Now at the plate, Manuel Margot, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Ball, that's outside.
The 1-0. 2-0 now.
Now you can see he's working around this guy right here. Why not? First base is open. Walk wouldn't be the worst thing in this spot.
2-1 to the Rays leadoff batter.
Wow, I can't believe the hitter took that one. The pitcher absolutely got away with a hanger.
All even now, 2-2. Even at 2-2. The pitch. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Judge is under it, and that ends the inning. All set for the start of the fourth. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
Giancarlo.
First pitch coming. Here it is. And that's in there for strike one. And low, it's a ball and a strike. Popped him up. Rousseau over to his left. One out. So the base is empty here with one away.
And that'll bring up the former American League Rookie of the Year, Big Aaron Judge.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And that misses for ball one. There's a cut fastball that time that runs in a bit too tight, and it's 2-0 now.
I wonder if that homer rattled him a little bit. He's certainly a little bit more cautious against him this time around.
Two balls and a strike now. 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. Now this pitch is swung on and popped up. And this will also head toward the right side of the infield. And there's out number two. Digging in, Torres, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Torres.
First offering on its way. And a curveball drops in there for strike one.
Hey, it's not always about filling up the strike zone all the time every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings, but interestingly, less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. High in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Down the first baseline. And that's through for a hit. Throw into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Now batting, the catcher, Kyle Higashioka.
At the plate, Kyle Higashioka. And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. And Meadows makes the catch for route number three.
Peanut.
And that'll bring in Yandy Diaz. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout.
The third baseman, Yandy.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
Diaz.
Now here's a swing and a little bouncer out to the left of the mound. And there's one away. Digging in, Randy Arozarena. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First pitch on its way. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. Here's a changeup that's right there, 1-1. And now a pitch on the way.
That's ball two.
Hit in the air out to center field. Hicks is under it. Two gone. Next to bat will be the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Brandon Lau. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks.
The center fielder, Aaron.
Here comes the first pitch. Here comes the 0-1. Sliced hard on the ground. Speared on the dive to first. Got him. Digging in, Jay Bruce. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
And the off-speed pitch is taken here, a ball and a strike. Two balls and a strike to the Yankees' first baseman. Now the 2-1. That's popped up. Diaz over to his right. Two gone. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Gio Urshela. 0 for 2 for him to this point.
Urshela.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. Ball one. One run on three hits and no errors for the Yankees so far. Now an off-speed pitch gets the outside. It's a called strike. Line shot to second, but it's caught and the side is retired. Leading off the inning, Willy Adames, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Not shortstop, Willy Adames.
Here's the first pitch to him. And this is taken outside for ball one. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And gone. An absolute bomb.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
Into the box now, Michael Brasso. As he'll look at a changeup that drops below the knees for ball one. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at-bat. A high fastball is in there. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch.
Ball.
Looked like a breaking ball that time, but it never came back down. Easy there, big fella. 2-2.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline in that. You get a count in your favor and you swing at a pitch that bad? Not good.
Hit high and deep out there to left center field. Looking up is Hicks. Gone!
A
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
Stepping in now, Yoshi Tsutsugo. As he swings and lifts it in the air out to left field. Therefore, it is Stanton, and he's got it for the first out. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Austin Meadows. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at-bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. Here's the pitch. Swing and a liner. But unfortunately, right at the shortstop for the second out.
Now batting.
Digging in to try it again, Mike Zunino. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. And he misses inside with that one, ball one. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. A ball and a strike to Mike Zunino. And this is low, ball two. 2-1.
Count is 2-1.
Hit to third. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and standing in is the DH, Clint Frazier. Here's the first pitch to him. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And he takes this one high, 1-1. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now.
The problem for the batter now is he's gotten so inside conscious after those first two pitches, anything on the outer half of the plate's going to look a foot outside.
Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Second baseman.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Yeah. 0-1's the count. Got a ball, one strike.
A ball and two strikes now.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
Skied into straightaway right. Meadows is underneath this one. Two gone. Striding forward now, the Yankee cleanup hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. In his last at-bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, Matty, and I think that pop-out was just a result of poor pitch selection. Got to see the pitch over the heart of the plate. He chased well out of the zone, and as a result, didn't really put a good swing on that.
2-0 to the Yankees left fielder.
2-0.
Maybe a bit of an overthrow there, guys. May have let that front side open up a little early to try to hump up on a fastball and sailed on it.
Set to deliver on 3-0.
Gotta believe he had the green light in that situation. Two outs, 3-0 count. This guy can certainly handle the bat. That's a perfect situation to let him loose. But I love the fact that he's key-holding a certain area, and it wasn't what he was looking for.
Grounded straight into the shift on the left side. And a backhanded try into the hole at short, but this gets on by.
The right fielder, number 99.
Here's big Aaron Judge. He'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch. It's strike one.
This is where you got to take stock in the situation. Adjust your batting gloves and realize you need a gapper to score this guy from first. If nothing less.
And the center fielder is under it to make the catch, and the inning is over.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in Manuel Margot. He'll get things started here in the second half of the sixth. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. The windup and the 0-1.
That's a ball.
Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike. No offer on that one, two balls and a strike.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his awesome.
Oh, look at the sliding stop in time. And what a vital play there, preventing the leadoff man from getting aboard. Now at the plate, Yandy Diaz. He was a groundout victim last time up. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0. And the pitch. Two balls and a strike.
The count, 2-1.
Line drive to center field. Hicks is there, two gone. Ready once again, Randy Arozarena. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Starts him with a breaking ball this time. Misses down and in for a ball. 1-0. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. The pitch. Low scoring game thus far. 2-1 here in the sixth. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. Up with it, Higashioka. And the throw to first ends the inning. Number 29 is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
Number 29, Peter.
Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
1-0 the count. Here it comes.
Ball two.
Don't expect this pitcher to throw something over the heart of the plate. He's going to have to stay on the corners right here. Huge spot in this game. Do not miss over the heart and get beat.
And there's the first strike, 2-1.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
A bouncer to the left side, fielded cleanly. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Digging in once again, Kyle Higashioka. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Well behind that fastball, it's a swinging strike.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
A ball and two strikes now. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
What pitch recognition right there. 90% of the guys are going fishing after that nasty slider.
Line to second, where it's caught there for out number 2.
Now back.
Stepping up to the plate, Aaron Hicks. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. First pitch of the at-bat. Strike 1 to start the at-bat. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
2 balls and a strike to count. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. And the pitch. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Brandon Lowe. And we thought we might be seeing the end of the road for the starter, but clearly he's still in there for at least one more hitter.
Yeah, I'm not sure, Matty, but I think this lefty-lefty matchup right here may have been enough to convince the manager to stay with him, so we'll see if it works out. Hey, this guy's pitching pretty well as we're rolling into the late innings. It's interesting, though, his first pitch strike percentage, less than 40% so far in this one.
And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
Not shortstop.
One out now in the Tampa Bay seventh, and up next will be Willy Adames.
And in that last at bat, it makes you think this guy might have went up there looking for the breaking ball, because he certainly got a breaking ball, and he didn't miss it. Hit it right on the screws.
It's been more than two innings since this guy's allowed anyone to reach base. He looks pretty unbeatable on the bump right now.
Here's a bouncing ball headed to LeMahieu at second, and there are two away now. Now to the plate, Michael Brasso comes in one for two with that home run he hit earlier.
And hey, it was a breaking ball to boot. This guy's a pretty good off-speed hitter. You could tell by that last at-bat, he wasn't fooled at all. He sat back, waited, got the breaking ball, and didn't miss it.
And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now. Outside, 3-0 now.
Now with the bases empty, I think he needs to be careful not to just groove one here just because it's 3-0. He's a guy that could ambush you.
Meanwhile, this ball is into right center, and that ought to be good enough for extra bases. And he is in the second with a two-out double. Nick Nelson takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning.
To go.
Standing in now, Yoshi Tsutsugo, as he'll take a breaking ball then off the plate for ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. Hicks going back to the track, and he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning. Colin McHugh has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 31, Colin.
Stepping in, Jay Bruce. He'll have a new pitcher waiting for him as we begin their half of the eighth.
Leading off for the Yankees, the first baseman, Jay.
First pitch coming, here it is. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one. And he lays off for ball one. Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Fouled off. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood in a broken bat.
He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Gio Urshela is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1. Heading out towards shallow right. Meadows has it, and there's one away. Next will be the designated hitter, Clint Frazier. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. And there's a line drive, base hit to left field. Tyler Wade will be summoned now to be the pinch runner.
Now batting, second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0. There's a fastball on the inner third taken for a strike.
3-1 with two on, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove him one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
Now the 3-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Margo will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two. So here's the cleanup hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. It was a single for him in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
I'm absolutely shocked he took that pitch right there. Right in a wheelhouse, low 90s heater. That's one you got to let go on.
One and two now. A ball and two strikes.
As a pitcher right there, do not be surprised if he throws the same exact pitch. He was lucky to foul that one off.
Outside, that's the ball.
And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Smoked on the ground up the middle. Throw on to first, and the Yankee threat goes by the boards as the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Austin Meadows. First pitch on its way. The windup and the 0-1. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. He's through first and hustling for second. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
Now batting, the catcher, Mike Zunino.
So here's Mike Zunino as the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. No hits to this point. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
Well executed fastball right at the knees. Going to be a long day for this offense if he stays in that spot.
One ball and two strikes to count. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. And another foul ball. And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
Number 13.
Runner at second. One away. And that'll bring up the versatile center fielder, Manuel Margot. No balls and one strike. From the stretch.
I got a ball, one strike.
And there's ball two now.
2-1.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Fastball too high, ball four.
Yandy Diaz.
First offering on its way. Yandy Diaz is at the plate, and he checks his swing for ball one.
He would have had to go with the old school Tommy Hawk approach on that one if he wanted to get on top, but he was able to lay off it.
Count now a ball and a strike. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Boy, this hole he's digging on the mound is all his doing. If you can't throw strikes, you're not going to be out there very long.
Oh, this is hit high and deep out to left. Stanton's back to the track as he takes it for out number two. Riding into the box, Randy Arozarena in a big at-bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the eighth. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Laid off the bender there, but it's in for a called strike. And he falls behind 0-2.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Diego Castillo comes on from the pen hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 63.
All set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge. First pitch on its way.
The right fielder, Aaron Judge.
Ball one, no sight.
The 1-0.
Ball. Two balls, no sight.
A wave and a miss at the 2-0 sinker, 2-1.
Looks to me like he's just trying to do too much up there at the plate. That's an easy trap to fall into when you're the tying run, but you can't be chasing pitches out of the zone.
Margo will slide over and put this one away, and that's out number one.
Up next for the Yankees.
Stepping into the box, Gleyber Torres. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
I'm seeing him just a little too amped up out there right now. That's common with hard throwers like him. Running a blazing fastball up there is great, but if you can't harness it, what good does it do you?
Sinker, and that's ruled strike two. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 2-2 one more time.
The count is full, 3-2.
And he looks at a sinker for a called third strike, and now there are two gone. The Yankees down to their final out. And up to bat next, it'll be the catcher, Kyle Higashioka. And a ball, 1-0. Breaking ball called just a bit low.
This at bat sets up really good right here, right? Hasn't seen a fastball yet, but now he gets to count at two balls and no strikes. He has to be looking for
throw in time, and the ball game is over.
Well, as a former pitcher, you know I love these low scoring games as opposed to those slugfests. This was like a throwback game when home runs weren't so common and pitching was really dominant. No complaints here.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. The Rays used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Michael Wacha gets the W on the mound. Jordan Montgomery pitched well, allowing only two earned, but ends up taking the loss. So that just about does it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ballgame, for the victorious Rays, 2 runs on 5 hits, no errors, they left 4.